Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the first part of my Academy 148 scale MiG-21 base build. This was a challenging build for me on two accounts. Firstly, I decided I would use some aftermarket parts on the kit, not realizing how poorly these said aftermarket parts were designed. And secondly, this paint scheme was itself a challenge, taking hours of masking. But in the end, the kit turned out pretty nice, and I'm happy that I stuck to the build despite coming close to quitting on a couple of occasions. Before we move on, please do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and do press the bell icon to stay updated about future posts. Also, if you enjoy the build, please do like the video and feel free to comment. Right then, let's take a look at the kit. Now you may notice that it says MiG-21MF and not BIS. But I am told that when this variant was inducted in the Indian Air Force, it underwent some minor changes and was redesignated the BIS. On the side, some really interesting paint schemes from several countries. As you can see, the Indian and the Hungarian variants are listed as the BIS. There are some really nice color schemes here, my favorite being the Hungarian yellow and the Egyptian scheme. The color callout on the other side. The kit number is 12311. The decals are by Kartograph, which is always good news. Let's take a quick look inside the box. Black and white instructions. Appears that the instructions and the color schemes are separate. We have three plastic bags of parts here. In all, five light grey plastic sprues. There is also a small clear plastic sprue inside one of the bags. Here is the Kartograph decal sheet. Let's take a closer look at the parts. Clean, crisp plastic with very nice detailing. Little to no flash, and so far I haven't seen any poorly placed ejection pin marks. Really nice overall. Here is the canopy, nice and clear. To check for distortion, I look at my fingerprints through the plastic, and this appears to be more or less distortion free. The instructions are standard fold out black and white Academy instructions, a little too old school for my liking. The only remarkable thing about the instructions is this stencil map. Looks like I will shortly be spending a couple of days fixing tiny stencils till my head starts spinning. Here are the color schemes, but I have chosen a rather unique color scheme from other reference material. Here are the aftermarket goodies that I got for this kit. Let's see, I have an Ares cockpit set with a cockpit tub and an ejection seat. And then I have this Czech Masters kits undercarriage set. Both these aftermarket parts claim to be customized for this kit, but having used these, I can assure you that is not the case. I had also got the ladder, pitot tube, and wheels, but I did not use them. I have a few more MiG-21 kits in the stash, and I will try and use these later. Not all was bad with my aftermarket purchases. This Edward canopy masking set was a joy to use, and gave smashing results. If you look at the pictures of the completed kit, you will see how cleanly the canopy seal is visible around the frame. This crisp finish was possible because of this masking set. 10 out of 10. Let's start with the resin cockpit. The detailing is nice enough. Apart from some problems with the headrest, the cockpit was nicely made. The first odd thing I came across was that for some reason, the dials on this film were brown. I really could not make out why this was so, but anyway, I decided to use them as they are not really that visible and I did not want to waste too much time waiting for new dials. The major problem with the cockpit aftermarket was the fit, as I was about to find out. After cutting the tub and cleaning it up, I decided to do some dry fitting, and I soon realized that I had two back plates behind the pilot seat. One on the kit and the second on the cockpit tub. Now usually this is not that much of a problem. All I would do is cut the plastic out of the kit part and go with the resin tub. However, the back plate on the tub is not the correct size. And to make matters worse, it is not the correct angle either. What I mean to say is that the angle on the resin tub does not match that on the plastic fuselage, which means that the two will not line up, and I will have to make them line up with some aggressive sanding. Anyway, the next step for now is to cut away the back plate of the plastic part. The front wheel well from the resin aftermarket set was also not the same dimension as the plastic kit part. This would have meant more sanding, putting, and trying to get things to line up. And already having to contend with the cockpit, I decided it would be best if I simply use the kit part for the front wheel well. I also cut and cleaned the nose cone and used liquid gravity and super glue to add weight to it. Next, we need to cut off these leg restraints on the ejection seat and reattach them at the correct angle. The leg restraints are almost at right angle to the seat. This is not correct. In the pictures I have seen, the restraints are at a much less of an acute angle. There is a more practical problem too. With the restraints at this sharp angle, the seat is not sitting properly in the tub. So I cut off the leg restraints and reattach them at the correct angle. all the interior parts are now given a coat of black. Next, I used Mr. Color 307 Grey for the interior. I really wanted to use the vibrant turquoise, which is often seen in MiG cockpits, but I was told that the MiGs in the Indian Air Force had their cockpit interior repainted in grey. Tragic. I hand paint the finer details in the cockpit. Here, I used a cocktail stick to pick out the tiny knobs and other details. Now the seat belts and the harnesses. For some reason, kit manufacturers are under the impression that this star-shaped harness is a shining example of brilliant design and engineering. I have no idea what gave them that impression, but they seem to try and cram one in every kit. The truth is that I personally find this design horrid and useless. You have to bend and shape the pieces in all directions, and it takes immense patience just to get the harness to an acceptable level. A good part of the parts have to be either cut off or simply left out just to make this monstrosity fit properly. Now, some dry brushing with aluminium. The instrument panel faces, which will have the dials, are painted white. The ejection seat looks very bland and unimpressive, so to jazz it up a bit, I turn to my stash of old tiny decals. I use some of these randomly to add more life to the ejection seat. There you go, much better. I now give all the parts a coat of Tamiya X22 clear. Once the clear was dry, I gave the parts an oil wash with black oil paint diluted with some turpentine. Any extra wash was later wiped away. I hand paint the dial rims with black. I now use the same X22 Claire to fix the plastic film with the dials on it to the instrument panel. Why the dials are brown, once again, is anyone's guess. Right then, I think this episode has dragged on for a bit now, so I will close this part 1 of the build here. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please do click the like button. As always, do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated about future posts. We will meet up soon with part 2 of the build. Till then, stay safe, good luck, and happy model making.